For a video like this one, I feel the need to start it with a real quick disclaimer, just to say, if you disagree, I completely understand. A topic like this is so subjective. The amount of different answers I have had when asking the question, who should dethrone Roman Reigns, it's absolutely insane how many different answers I've had. So if you disagree, I completely understand. The point of this video is me pitching a case, is me laying out some groundwork, laying out some, I guess, theories, evidence, and what have you, and making you at the end of the video think, yeah, if they did that, that wouldn't be the worst idea. I'd be down for that. You know, that's the kind of point in this video. So, with that being said, let's just get into this. So, Roman Reigns has been Universal Champion now for basically 1 year, okay? Whether you're watching this after he's ticked over a year or whether he's not in a year yet, regardless, he's held the Universal Championship for basically a year. And still at this point, there's no real clear, evident one guy who's just the default, this guy needs to beat Roman Reigns guy. That guy doesn't exist. Names have been floated out there, be that Drew McIntyre, be that Big E, be that Seth Rollins, be that Finn Balor, be that Dwayne Johnson, John Cena, Edge. I've seen names like Kevin Owens, and I've seen a plethora of names to dethrone Roman Reigns. But in my opinion, based off watching WWE in the past couple months, and watching WWE as far as how they're treating their talent, how they're booking talent, potential long-term stories and angles they can go for, there's one man who I genuinely think, in the long run, is a really good shout for dethroning Roman Reigns. And that man, some people are going to scoff at this, but hear me out. This video is going to be all about hearing me out. So, this guy is Baron Corbin. Now, right now, Baron Corbin is undergoing an immense character shift. This guy, for the better part of, God, what was that, a year and a half, was running around as some, like, early 90s king gimmick with the crown and the scepter, just a stereotypical, generic, pretty bland king gimmick. I mean, it was just meh. Like, he had the six-month-long feud with babyface Roman Reigns, he had the dog food involved, and then there was a Corbin and Elias storyline, and Corbin was in the mid-card blender on SmackDown for a while, and he was just kind of there, and he was there, and nothing was really happening, and eventually he loses his crown. Okay, Baron Corbin loses his crown to Shinsuke Nakamura, and the character totally changes. Corbin goes broke. Corbin becomes down bad, and I want to commend Baron Corbin a lot, because this guy, for many a year, has received immense scrutiny, criticism, and slander online for being boring, bland, dry, bad at his job, not good, etc., etc. But really, Baron Corbin, as this down bad or sad Baron Corbin gimmick, genuinely, he's been bloody brilliant. This is the kind of stuff that entertains people. This is the kind of stuff that's legitimately funny. This is a 6'7" former football player from Kansas City who's absolutely down horrendous, okay? In kayfabe, he's lost absolutely pretty much everything he had. He was forking out too much money when he was getting king checks. When he was making $20,000 a week, he was forking out too much money. He was buying expensive things. Now everything's caught back up to him. He can barely cover costs. He has to sell off cars. He has to make a GoFundMe page. It's incredible. And you look at that guy, where he is now. He's getting genuine babyface sympathy. He's getting genuinely fans thinking, this is, like, good. Like, a Baron Corbin segment comes on now. Baron Corbin comes out, like, crying about how broke he is and how down bad he is. And people are genuinely invested. No longer does Baron Corbin come on the screen and your default auto-reaction, outside of a few people who are Corbin fans, is to rush to the remote control and change the channel to watch literally anything else. Okay? I remember about a year and a bit ago, during about May of 2020, when Baron Corbin was closing SmackDown, posing with the Money in the Bank briefcase, thinking, oh my god, I'm just going to binge watch 6 hours straight of Judge Judy just to try and cleanse my palate from that absolute filth. Okay, that was Corbin then. Now, Corbin is legitimately captivating and entertaining. So, that's Corbin now. He's a legitimately entertaining, captivating, funny entertainment act in the mid-card. So how elitist does that guy dethrone Roman Reigns? Roman Reigns hasn't lost or been pinned clean this decade. Okay, granted, this decade's only been going for what? Let's do some quick maths here. About 19 and a tick months. It's only been going for 19 and a tick months. It's only been going for a bit over a year and a half. So you're exaggerating. Okay, nonetheless. But the fact of the matter is, Roman Reigns hasn't been pinned this decade. The last time Roman Reigns was pinned was, well, I mean, let me just roll the clip right now. You see that? You see the guy who just pinned him? You see who that is? Does that guy ring a bell? Was I just talking about that guy for about 3 minutes and praising him? Yeah, that's Baron Corbin. Now, granted, that was in the midst of a pretty cringeworthy heel Corbin, and you had the revival involved, and there was Ziggler and Rude. That was messy, and you had babyface Big Dog Reigns, who was just So you had that. Corbin pinned Reigns there because of all that, but nonetheless, that's a clean pinfall. That's the last time Roman Reigns has been pinned clean. So, with that considered, don't you think you take this Baron Corbin, a guy who fans are legitimately getting behind, finding entertaining, just giving good reactions to now, giving babyface reactions, you take that guy, give him, oh, I don't know, 6 to 9 more months of legitimately good build, good writing, logical writing, he's down bad for a bit longer, for a couple months, you really make the most out of him being down horrendous, then he begins the babyface arc, the hero's journey, he begins getting a couple of wins, still takes some losses, then he maybe wins the Intercontinental title, then he'll drop it, and then eventually, he'll finally turn his attention to Roman Reigns. Now, I don't think that's a horrible idea, especially considering what else there is. As I mentioned earlier in this video, there aren't a plethora of guys who are just that much better of options, okay? There isn't just a pool of talent in NXT who is just ripe to dethrone Roman Reigns. That doesn't exist. There aren't a bunch of main roster guys who are just ripe for the picking to dethrone Reigns. That doesn't exist. So, with that being said, I genuinely don't think it is that bad of an idea. You have a babyface Baron Corbin, a guy who, in and of himself, was the last guy to pin Roman Reigns clean. Now Baron Corbin is on this babyface arc, he's down horrendous, he's at absolute rock bottom, okay? Now what you can do is use the magic of storytelling and logical creative writing to book this guy well for near enough a year from now, and then you can have this big moment, whether a SummerSlam 2022 or God knows where it is, where Baron Corbin, after going from absolute rock bottom in the heart of 2021 to fighting his way back in a hero's journey, dethrones Roman Reigns, who would have held the title for about 2 years. Okay, some people won't like that. I completely understand. Okay, when Roman Reigns loses the title, it's going to be the most disputed and, you know, conjecture-filled title loss in really wrestling for the past decade. This Roman Reigns title run is the most heavily debated who should he lose it to reign I can ever remember. And the fact of the matter is, not everyone's going to agree. That is totally cool. If you believe Finn Balor should retain the... Oh, dethrone Roman Reigns, fair play to you, you're wrong. But nonetheless, if you believe that Big E should beat Roman Reigns, I mean, I disagree. I think Big E should beat Lashley. I think that makes way more sense. If you think Seth Rollins should be the babyface guy to dethrone Reigns, I mean, fair play to you. The thing I say to that, we saw babyface Seth Rollins as the main event world champion in 2019. What did that give us? Can someone tell me that? So that was that. And then, yeah, if you want a part-time to do it, fair play. But I genuinely think Baron Corbin, from believability, the fact that the guy is a 6'7" former football player, the character arc, him going from absolute rock bottom to reaching the highest possible high in wrestling in potentially like a year from now of dethroning Roman Reigns, the fact that Baron Corbin was the last guy to pin Roman Reigns, I think that can have some weight to it as well. I think the dynamic of a tribal god Roman Reigns just bullying Baron Corbin, I think could be entertaining, and Baron Corbin getting a massive babyface, just near enough upset win to close his character arc. I think that whole thing just works. Granted, you might not like it, but I just think out of all the options we have now, that's probably the best bet as far as a full-time guy. Because, I mean, you can have a babyface Big E announce a cash-in match and then beat Roman Reigns with 3 big endings or something. I mean, you can do that, I guess. Or you can have, I guess, Finn Balor beat Roman Reigns in a great match as Finn Balor's holding the title on the top rope with his testicles popping out. I guess you can do that. But in reality, you compare those options to a well-written Baron Corbin goes from rock bottom to the absolute highest of highest character arc. I just... I don't see how you wouldn't want to say that. So that's just me. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to like, comment, subscribe. It's not a drill. See ya.